Folks, it is now time for Roxanne's story here on the MJ Morning Show. Roxanne came to me earlier this week and said, well, actually, you sent an email first.
I did.
You said, and I have the email right here. You sent an email. I have the most insane thing that happened to me about 2 months ago, and I've been trying to decide if I want to share it on the air. I think I'm getting closer to wanting to share it, but I need to talk to you in advance and pick a day when we have lots of listeners, because it's good. Yeah, what day has more listeners? I mean, it's pretty yeah. pretty constant.
Today's a good day.
Yeah. Yeah, listen, the measuring system is all over the road.
But is midweek listenership higher because you're in the middle of the work week?
I don't think so.
Okay,
it's hump day. We're at the hump of the week.
So Roxanne has something that happened to her 2 months ago. She wants to discuss it. Roxanne is seemingly suggesting this was life-changing. But then Roxanne sends me ground rules last night.
Yeah, ground rules.
Rules for you during my story. Don't paint me as a one-dimensional, weirdo while I'm telling the story. Feel free to interrupt me as I'm telling the story, but only with high caliber humor as opposed to rudeness or dumb questions.
Sometimes high caliber humor is my dumb question.
Roxanne, do you want me to throw something at him every time he interjects?
Yes, please.
I mean, I could throw a pen.
I'm not telling this story to get you or any other listeners to go do this. I don't want to give it away. Or to blank. So this is not a for or against argument. Anyway, here's the, ladies and gentlemen, Roxanne's story, something that happened to her 2 months ago that she's finally ready to tell us, which she has characterized as amazing.
Okay, so you know that I think I give a lot emotionally on this show. I think I give the most emotionally. I think you give the most intellectually, MJ. Froggy gives the most physically with his stunts. And Fester is just the most. So
it's a Super Tramp song. Give a little bit.
I haven't done a stunt in 2 years.
Give a little bit of my craziness to you.
Built up a hell of a mess.
So this is a very emotional story. It's going to be ups and downs, but I promise it's going to be a lot of laughs and fun. Okay. It's going to start off a little sad. I've told you guys my best friend passed this year, this summer, diagnosed with aggressive breast cancer. And so she passed. And so I was having a hard time with it. And I was at a different friend's house over the summer 2 months ago. And my friend says, I knew that she'd talked to a medium before. And she was like, we're hanging out all day and got to be nighttime. She's like, Roxanne, do you want to call my friend? And I'm like, nah, I'm good. And this is the part where MJ, you think I'm into all this stuff. You know, my father died 6 years ago. I have never talked to a medium. I'm not really into that. Okay.
But
I do like astrology. Yes, I do. I think you're an Aquarius. And but so then she said, I promise you. I'm like, she's like, this isn't fortune telling. This isn't like, oh, this is going to happen, blah, blah, blah. It's just
friend talked you into going to like Whoopi Goldberg from the movie Ghost?
Hey.
No, she just.
No.
What?
Don't interject.
He's allowed to interject.
You just threw a pen at my
Roxanne
arm.
Roxanne gave me the eye.
No, rule number three was interject with only high caliber jokes. I thought that was really good.
All right, go ahead.
I was going to follow that up with MJ, the kind of one that Pee Wee Herman went to. Yes. It's at the Alamo.
Oh my God. So your friend talks you into going to a medium?
No, calling. Because I'm at her house still. I've been there all day. And so we decide where she goes, I'm going to call her right now and tell her, I'm going to text her and see if she's available. So she texts her and says, all right, do you have time to talk to us? She goes, yeah, call me in 10 minutes.
Woo!
MJ, Froggy, did you hear what he just did? He played a woo!
Stop throwing crap at me!
All right, hey, listen.
Froggy, you knew it.
That stung. You threw a Sharpie at me at full pitch.
Roxanne, if you're going to come into this dojo and tell your story, MJ's going to make his comments too.
No but mercy. I don't want the oohs, okay? So
you're
listen.
Talking about a clamvoyant?
a clamvoyant.
So far, Roxanne.
Is that a steamed clamvoyant? Mm.
Roxanne, right, so far
or a
is
fried clamvoyant.
It's a fried clamvoyant.
MJ, that's a one. That's a one, okay? You get three, just like my kids. You get to the count of three. That's a one.
Did this woman.
You spank us?
Did the woman you speak to.
That's great.
Did the woman you speak to have like a big fruit hat like Miss Cleo?
I spoke to her on the phone. I never saw her. So this is what happened. So my friend says, I promise you.
Oh, you didn't hold hands at a seance?
No. She says, I promise you, you're just going to feel better after you talk to her. So she gets on the phone with me. All she knows about me is my name. She says, okay, here's my friend Roxanne. We're hiding in her and my friend's closet because we don't want her husband to hear us or interrupt us.
Right.
So we're in the closet. We call her.
Did you record the phone call?
No, but she told me, she said, you know, get a pen and paper and right. start to write things down.
I recorded the phone call.
You have questions. I have the answer.
MJ.
Who asked you to go out of town? The stupid young one or the married one?
The married one.
That's what I thought. Don't go. You hear me?
MJ. No.
All right, I'm sorry. Go ahead, Roxanne. Okay.
So we're on the phone and all she knows about me is my name's Roxanne. And I tell her, I go, I'm not going to say anything. I'm just going to let her talk. I'm not going to say a word. Right? So first thing she says to me, she said, there's a father energy. I feel very strong male energy talking right now. I know what you're going to say. 50-50, right? Could be a female energy, could be male energy. She got it right. She got it right. All right. So she says, now listen, if you guys ever met my dad, when every person we ever met, whoever commented on, oh, Rob, your daughter's adorable or your daughter's cute or whatever, the first thing he would say is he wouldn't say thank you. He wouldn't say anything like that. He would say, look at me. She got her good looks from me. That is exactly what he would say. All right. So she says this male energy is here. And I was like, okay. He's telling me you got your good looks from him. It's the first thing she says. Okay.
Okay.
So then she says the number.
Are you paying by the minute?
I knew you were going to ask that, but
how much did you pay for this?
Did you have to put a credit card in, like punch in the numbers on your credit card?
I didn't pay anything. Okay. So we're going to continue. So then she says, he says, you're always going to be my little girl. My dad definitely said that to me all the time, even in my 30s. Talked about the number. She said the number 3 is important. We would always go to dinner on Valentine's Day. And my dad would be like, I have my three Valentines. You know, even when husbands and Doug were in the picture, he'd be like, sorry, these are my 3 Valentines. And then, you know, so she's just a lot of stuff. I'm not going to go point by point.
Thank you.
But okay, that is a chew. That is a chew. Again.
All right, I'm sorry.
Here comes another one.
Yes, that is a chew.
Violence is never the answer, Frosty.
You know what's coming next? I got a cue ball right
here. Whoa.
So then she says, he's saying the name like Anthony or Tony. I'm like, what? I go, we're not Italian. So she goes, just write it down. It might not mean anything to you. Just write it down.
Did she say Carmela next?
How is this like psychic phone medium? How is it just available for you to call just on hot standby and you're at your friend's house?
Yes.
Hey, let's call my psychic medium and you can get a reading over the phone.
Yes.
Just like instantly you guys, like tea and crumpets and like, hey, let's call my on-demand standby psychic medium.
That's exactly what happened. I forgot to tell you the important second thing that was said, and my father drowned. And so she said, he wants you to know he can breathe and that it happened very fast and everything is fine. He's fine. He can breathe. That was the second thing she told me after Roxanne got her good looks from me. He also said, don't call her.
Your friend fed.
No, MJ, she would never do that. She would never do that. My friend would never do that.
What are you? Your friend's not a carny. You do it.
Okay, is your friend a carny?
No.
Can your friend guess my weight?
Now, Roxanne, okay.
Okay, go ahead. Listen, when I tell this story, I find some things that are very, very like ubiquitous. Like, okay, I can breathe now. Well, everybody who dies stops breathing. So that's kind of, you know, across the board, that's kind of vague. So you can poke holes in this. When I tell this story, sometimes I'm like, I don't know if I believe it myself.
Yeah, I'm not a believer in this stuff.
That's fine.
I think that there are a lot of generalities are thrown out.
I agree.
And I don't believe that this psychic that you were on the phone with at a friend's house was in communication and channeling your deceased father's thoughts.
This isn't a story about your beliefs. This is a story about what I listened to her say on the phone, whether she was... Look, there are 3 kinds of mediums. One is a charlatan, and they know they're not talking to dead people, and they're just trying to screw you over. The other really is. We don't know that, if they are, they aren't. And the other, maybe they aren't really talking to your dead relative, but they think they are. I can promise you she wasn't a charlatan kind. She was one of the other two. Either she thinks she was, or she really was. Okay? I don't know.
Roxanne.
So then he said...
Oh, dude.
Listen!
Roxanne, hang on a minute. I'm getting a message. I'm getting a message now.
Hey, who is this talking?
I'm getting a message.
Okay, this is important.
So,
I'm getting a message. It's it's the cash kitty. I'd hang on.
Did the medium know the word?
The cash kitty.
Did the medium say the
word should. At 8 o'clock on October 4th?
The cash kitty was run over by a car. It's
oh, no.
Yeah. The medium is now communicating with the cash kitty. And folks, this hour's word is play. Back to Roxanne's story in a minute. This hour's word is play. P-L-A-Y. So text the word play right now nationwide to 45911 before quarter after for a shot at $1,000 cash, or you can enter it on the Q105 app or at myq105.com. Roxanne, I want to grab some phone calls on this.
No, not yet. We will eventually, but not yet.
Well, hold on. How long do you think this segment's going
to
be?
I haven't even gotten to the... I haven't scratched the surface of the good stuff.
I'm going to scratch it.
Let's go.
Get the good stuff right now. Go.
Okay. So he said, do not call her Roxy. Her name is Roxanne. My dad never wanted anyone to call me anything except Roxanne. And then she started telling me all these things that he said in real life. In real life, the way she captured what he was about. He was like braggadocious, but in a fun way. She's like, he's laughing all the time. Like, she just nailed it. You know what?
Oh my
okay,
God.
Okay, that's a
you're
three.
A jerk.
You know what? All right, everybody. No. You can listen to the rest of this story from 10 to 2 today. I'll give it to you in bits and pieces, especially the part where my dad says, play Ticket Tuesday and you will win $5 million
the really good stuff.
I'm getting to it.
Did she make stuff move in your friend's house?
So was your dad the only person she talked about?
No. Okay. Are you guys ready for me to continue?
My God, for real. We're really, show some respect.
We're respectfully encouraging you.
Okay. So that I will walk out of this studio. Don't think I won't.
Oh, no.
All right. I'm not going to do it because I know that the listeners want to hear this. So he said this name Anthony or Tony, and it didn't mean anything to me at first. So then a few minutes later, I start to think about it. I start laughing so hard because Anthony is the first boy that I kissed when I was in seventh grade and we were on a cruise ship, me and my dad and my sister. And my dad would always tease me about it. And he'd be like, oh, Roxanne kissed Anthony, Tony, whatever the guy's name is. Anthony,
how old were you?
I was going into seventh grade. Anthony, by the way, he kissed like this. Watch.
Oh, I was going to ask.
It was crazy.
Hey,
it was like super fast, like a lizard tongue.
Did you just get her?
Oh, like a lizard.
Roxanne just did lizard tongue all over the place.
I didn't kiss anyone else after that for like two years.
Right.
Okay, so anyways, that was one funny thing. So at this point, I've said nothing to her, not a word, not one word, and she's given me all this. And I'm starting to feel it now. I'm starting to get nostalgic because I don't care what your opinion is, MJ. I'm just telling you how I was feeling. So I'm like feeling like all these things I forgot about my dad are coming back to me. So then
that's nice.
Right. And then I said, you know, there's one thing that I'm sad about. I'm sad he didn't get to meet my kids. Right. So then she's like, oh, don't worry that, you know, your children, he's telling me your children keep him alive. And my kid, I'm stop crying in a second. I'm fine. So I'm like, I do make my children all the time look at pictures of him and talk about him. They always talk about Grandpa Rob, even though they never met him. So then she said to me, she's like, this is very, very important.
All right, you can't start crying because then you're going to make it difficult for me to poke holes.
Froggy,
stop it.
You stop.
Let her go. Let her go. All right. Go ahead, Rob.
Well, I just don't believe that.
I don't care if you believe it. I don't know if I do. I don't know if I do. Right. I don't know if I believe.
This isn't about you, MJ.
It's not about you. It's not about. I don't know if I believe this. Isn't what I'm saying. I'm telling you what I was feeling. So she goes, this is very important. What he wants me to tell you right now. He's saying in the room with you. So me and my girlfriend start laughing because we're like, we don't want him in the room with us. We're just talking a lot of girl crap.
Oh,
10 minutes earlier.
Did like a candelabra fly through the air?
No. Listen, that wasn't it. So when I gave birth to my daughter.
Like the headless specter in the Scooby-Doo cartoon?
When I gave birth to my first daughter, it was a rough go as most pregnancies are. And this is a long thing. It's middle of the night. And I finally was able to do it. And I was holding her, and Doug told me a week later, he goes, I don't want to freak you out, but I looked in the corner of the room. Doug is not like this. He's like you guys. Like, But he's like, I saw your dad sitting in the chair.
No, what? Stop it. Yeah. God, let's go. I want to go to phones on this.
No, you're not. I'm not done. I'm going to continue.
I want to look. Well, how long? This is with
Doug saw it.
Right, listen, I want to go to. Let me load up phones.
We'll talk to Doug.
I load them up, but I have more to say. So that's going to blow your mind.
Now, Dig Doug, you're claiming listen, saw your deceased father sitting in a chair in the room?
Doug.
Oh my.
All right, how many White Claws did he have that day?
Oh my.
Listen.
All right, let's go to phones.
That was what he was referring to in the room.
Let me give out the number.
And I go, oh my gosh, I know what that is. It's because I tell that story to people.
Let me give out the phone number. 800-990-1047. 800-990-1047. Folks, I'd love you. You've heard a lot from Roxanne. Listen, I'm not a Johnny come lately as far as being a skeptic. It's not Roxanne. There's nothing personal here for Roxanne. I'm not attacking Roxanne's story. It's not a personal thing. I have always been skeptical. I don't believe in mediums and psychics. I just don't believe in it. Let's grab calls on this. So you've heard portions of Roxanne's story, and Roxanne is a little more. Then we'll go to phones. 800-990-1047. Roxanne's been holding on to this for 2 months and finally, earlier this week, says, hey, I got something I want to talk about. I've now decided I want to talk. 2 months later, look at the phones. Every line is jammed.
I'm enjoying it, Roxanne.
800-990-1047. That's how you get on. I want to grab your phones. 800-990-1047. And Roxanne, and listeners, don't take my skepticism or, you know, poking holes or, you know, don't take it personally. This is not, we love Roxanne. It's just, I wouldn't believe this if it was somebody else or,
it's not personal. I hate to tell you this, yeah. But I'm happy that you haven't lost anyone as close to you as I was to two people who I've lost. So you don't think about this stuff as much.
No, but
I don't want you to. You're not there yet, but someday you will.
Listen, and of course, it's life. Things are going to happen. But don't try to guilt me into
feeling bad
about my disbelief of some psychic on a phone.
You're very confused about this because I've told you I don't know if I believe this. I'm repeating the story because it affected me. Right. I don't know that I believe. Sometimes when I tell the story to other friends, I'm like, yeah, this is kind of vague. But I want to tell you how it made me feel and the revelation it made me have.
So, MJ, let her finish.
Can I go to phones here in a moment? Can you just
I'll wrap it up.
Wrap it up
with two quick things.
Yep.
My friend came in. She said I'm someone with a letter J. Well, my friend's name began with the letter J. We start talking. I was very worried when she passed. You know, about being in pain. And she said, first thing I want you to know is I feel so good. I told her so many things in the hospital when I didn't know if she could or could not still hear me, and she said that stuff back to me. She said, your daughter has a beautiful singing voice. She said, the color purple, and my friend got me this purple bracelet after her mom gave it to me after. I know these are vague things. You could pick any color and find some relevance, but I'm just going to leave you with this about my friend.
You know, Roxanne, we've known you for 3 years, and I love knowing you. I love you being part of the show, but you know that I've always been skeptical.
It's not about you, MJ. The story isn't about you. You're the host of this show.
Tell her story.
But you're telling the story, and I'm offering my opinion.
Again and again. It's the same opinion.
Fester, just
clam
it up. But this is not a Johnny-come-lately deal for me.
Fried clams or steamed clams?
Whether it's you or somebody else, I've always been...
Good for you. I'm a skeptic too. That's the part of it.
All right, so what are the final things you want to say before we grab calls?
So then she said, she's talking to me about a drawing that your daughter did. She's telling me about a drawing your daughter did with hearts and with little hearts and rainbows. And the day prior, my daughter, here, Fester, you can hand my phone to him. That's the drawing that my daughter did.
Hearts and rainbows.
Little hearts.
And a big rainbow.
So you're claiming that this picture, which I'm showing on MJTV right now, you're claiming that your daughter drew this a couple of days before you were on the phone with Miss Cleo?
The day before.
The day before you were talking to the psychic on the phone at your friend's house. And so your daughter, kids draw hearts and rainbows. Well, wait, I don't see any hearts.
Where are
the? Oh, I do see.
They're little.
No, I see the hearts. All right, so you're saying that your daughter drew this picture the day before the phone call with the psychic.
Yes.
And then what exactly did the psychic say a day later?
Little hearts and rainbows. A drawing. She's telling me a drawing about little hearts and rainbows.
In what context?
That's all she said. She goes, she said, your friend is telling me about a drawing with little hearts and rainbows. And that's exactly what my daughter drew.
So her friend saw the picture that Roxanne's daughter drew.
Whoa.
So, right. Yeah. And okay. So this is the repeated message. And this is what I want people who have lost someone to. Oh, my friend also said, keep traveling. You entertain me. The whole time we had a relationship on Earth. Anytime I go on a trip, I'm calling her the whole time for the trip, telling her what's going on. And so, you know, anyways, a lot of stuff that really resonated with me. Whether it's true or not, whether it's vague or not, whatever, this is what I took from this conversation, and I want to share it with people who've lost someone. Talk about your family member who you've lost, because it keeps them alive. I knew that.
Listen, I have no problem with remembering, and of course we should remember our loved ones. We should cherish the time. We're going to feel sad. We're going to be upset. My issue has nothing to do with that.
You don't have an issue. This is a story you're listening to. You have no issue.
No, it just has to do with a psychic. And they're experts at throwing out all kinds of generalities. Fester, this is a conversation. It's not a Roxanne monologue.
Let her get it out.
Suddenly you're all sympathetic, Mr. All right, go ahead, Roxanne.
Okay, all I want to say is it really got me thinking about what happens when we die. And I believe in heaven. That's my belief. I know a lot of people don't. A lot of people think we take a dirt nap. I believe we have a spirit. We're not a computer that you can go smash and then it just doesn't exist. We still have something inside of us. And I realize, like, what drew me into what she was saying, I don't know if I believe her or not. I don't know if she was hoodwinking me, but I felt the personality or the spirit of my two lost loved ones who I knew very, very, very well. But what was different about them is that it was absent of pain or of shame or like addiction or anything that we deal with on this earth that holds us down. That is what happens to your spirit when you die. Like, you don't have any of that. And it just gave me a lot of comfort. And I know other people have lost people and wonder what happens. And I think it's all good.
Cheryl's in Riverview. Cheryl, you're on the MJ Morning Show. Hi, Cheryl.
Good morning. How are you? So I am of the same mindset of Roxanne. So I do believe there are charlatans and they're fakers, but I've had a couple of run-ins myself with a couple of psychics that really freaked me out. And one I will share with you encounter happened early 90s, back in the days of the Ron and Ron show. They used to have some guy on there, and I really didn't believe him, and I called in, and I was told that my mother was killed in a car accident, a freak accident, and she was decapitated.
Oh, my and God.
Was that guy have a white wig? Like, is he Gary Spivey? Right?
I'm like, no way, that's so crazy. Jeez. So let's fast forward later on, and I'm adopted, and I never knew who my mother was until Ancestry.com and DNA reveals who my family is.
Oh, no, then you found a news story about her being decapitated in a car accident?
Yes.
Oh, my
what?
God.
Wow.
I found my family to confirm it, and I found the death certificate. So explain that. I have no idea, but that is crazy, and it happened, and it's true.
Wow.
Yeah, again.
It was Gary Spivey. He's good.
Cheryl, thanks for the call. Heidi.
Hey, Cheryl.
Heidi and Mulberry. Hello, Heidi. You're on the MJ Morning Show.
Hi, everybody. So my granddaughter, when she was about 4, it's Thanksgiving, and we're headed out for the day, and she had never met my mother, and yet she sits beside me, and she said, I just want to tell you, I talked to your mom. And I was like, oh, really now? Because she had never met my mother. And she said, and she just wanted me to tell you that she does not want turkey for dinner. She just wants a hamburger from McDonald's with extra onions. Now, we talked about my mom a lot. And again, she's just a little child. I believe people know things. I don't know if I believe in psychic, but I believe people have some sort of intuition that they know things. And it's kind of creepy. So for that whole year of her life, she would just randomly pop off with the fact that she knew things about my mother, someone that she had never met, she had only ever seen pictures of, and we never discussed what she ate or anything, you know, just like, this is your great-grandma or this and that. But, you know, so put a little bit of thought into it and believe what you feel you need to believe and just go with that.
All right. Heidi, thanks for the call. Rebecca's in Tampa. Rebecca, you're on the MJ Morning Show.
Hi. Yeah, I texted Roxanne the other day. Hi, Roxanne.
Hi.
Yeah, I'm with Roxanne on this one. I think I have a lot of skepticism, too, but my mother actually had an experience, not me. My mom had her best friend in college was kind of like emotionally troubled. I don't know if it was a disorder or something, but just had a lot of emotional breakdowns and things like that, and ended up killing herself when she was in her 50s. And my mom had a medium come to our house. I wasn't living there at the time, but she had a medium come to her house. And after her parents died, so this was many, many years after her friend committed suicide.
So what happened?
So the medium came in, and there's a lot of pictures around, like just family pictures and whatever. And there's a framed photograph of a postcard. And the medium came and picked up the framed photograph of a postcard. You'd have no idea that it's a postcard. It just looks like a picture of, like, a New Orleans street.
And what happened?
And that was, like, and the medium said, oh, I'm gravitated towards this picture. Is this really important?
Well, if you've got a picture in a frame in your house, then obviously there's some importance to the picture. That's just generalization.
Well,
that's
there's a story. There's a story associated with this picture. Like, someone's telling me that this is, like, a really important picture. And the picture was the last letter that my mom received from her best friend that committed suicide right before she committed suicide.
All right. Listen, you know, a lot of intricate stories here. It's just, I think there are explanations for everything. And there's just the psychics, by and large, they know how to hone in on generalities. They play the game of averages and they play the odds with a lot of their pokes and guesses. Thanks for the call.
800, that's what you think.
800-990-1047. 800-990-1047. All right, a couple of additional calls. Then we got to move on. But, you know, Roxanne has certainly delivered a very, you know, thought-provoking segment here.
Except for the parts where you're poking your little nose in.
Those parts really didn't invoke any thought at all.
No,
I'm gonna be
repetitive.
I'm going to be the same person that I am, whether it's a Roxanne story or not. I've always been skeptical of this. Suddenly, with Roxanne's story, I'm not going to be like, oh, my God, I believe you. That's amazing.
That's not it.
You are missing the whole point. All we were saying was don't interrupt her so damn much. What? That's all we
Hold
were
on.
Saying.
Mr. Interrupter, suddenly you're Mr. Johnny Do-Good over here? Jill's in Largo. Jill, you're on the MJ Morning Show. Hi.
Son of a bitch. Hello.
Hello, Jill. You're on the MJ Morning Show. Go ahead.
Hello. Sorry, I was listening on the app on my other phone so I could hear all the stories while I was working.
Yeah.
I got another phone so I could call you guys and not miss out.
Give me more details about your life.
Hold on. You have two phones, one to listen to us on and one to call people on?
Well, I have two phones for my social retail business and my
okay. Anyway, I love the commitment. Thank you, Jill.
What do you sell?
At the same time, it's so awesome. But anyway, Roxanne, my mother, when she passed away, my grandmother came in the room as a rainbow figure. And people do support you even when they're gone in the afterlife. They come back to you and they tell you that they love you. And if you just listen to them, they're really there. And I just want to tell you, I support you 100%.
Thanks, Jill.
Thank you.
Holly is in Mulberry. Holly, MJ Morning Show. You're up. Go.
Hi, good morning. Roxanne, I agree with you. Okay, I've never been to a psychic. However, my mother-in-law at the age of 95 passed away 5.5 years ago. And I was taking my dog for a walk. And there was Mom in the window. I saw her standing there. And every once in a while, this woman that I loved so much, she turns off the kitchen dining room light on us.
She turns the dining room light off?
All right. Okay. The dining room light will shut off.
Sounds like you need to call an electrician, but that's just my opinion.
And we, no. We don't need no electrician. It's Mommy. she is always there. And Roxanne, I support you on this. Like I say, I have never, ever been to a psychic.
Holly, thanks for the call. I appreciate your thoughts.
Thank you. Have a great day.
You too, Holly. Phones have exploded. All right. Andrew, no more calls. Let me just clear the board here. And listen, folks, you never know what you're going to get from the MJ Morning Show. That's the beauty is you turn the show on any given day. You have no idea what could be coming your way. Wendy is in Venice. Wendy, MJ Morning Show. Hi.
Good morning.
Hi, Wendy. Go ahead.
So, I agree with the generalities on things, but mine was so specific, it blew me away. I went to this, somebody gave me a gift, and they were mediums, and she read from a regular deck of cards. She told me, don't tell me anything, only answer yes and no to my questions. So I shuffled the cards, I put them down, and I said my first name, and that was it. So when these people come in, she feels them physically. And my father-in-law passed away, and she says, I feel something in my throat. She says, my father-in-law died of esophageal cancer. So she says, who's Bill? And I said, my dad. And she says, is he with us? And I said, yeah. And she said, he's not with us. I went, oh, that's my father-in-law. That's my father-in-law, my father's name, Bill. So she pulled his name from, I have no idea where. And she said, he wants to tell you something. And she said, he wants you to know that you are good for his son. And that made complete sense to me because I found out later on my ex was a narcissistic, bad person. And I didn't know that at the time, but so he told me that. He also told me that I was moving. I was not, in my mind, I had the house in my dreams. I was not moving. She said, well, you're moving. And then she told me my ex was having an affair. And I was like, no way. There was no way in heck right. I thought he was having an affair. So she was telling me all this stuff. And then a year later, all this stuff came through, every last bit of it. So when my mother came in, the weird thing was when my mother came in, she said, I feel something on my chest. My mother died of breast cancer. And when I asked her about it, she looked and she says, it's complete dark. I don't see anything. So that was really strange that my mother, when my mother died, it was purple and yellow flowers. That was her funeral, her father's, favorite colors. And when that summer in my sister's lawn that she's been living in for 15 years, the whole grass came up with little yellow, purple, and yellow flowers in her entire lawn.
Oh, that's like a movie or something. Thank you, Wendy. Appreciate the call.
Just zip it up. Just zip it up, man.
The only guy to call in so far is Jason in Tampa. Jason, you're up. Hello.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Doing well.
MJ, you really let me down today. You were so non-sympathetic to letting her speak. It seems like, and even when she was getting emotional, you slid a joke in. Fester, I thank you for standing up. Normally, your MJ's, yes, man, but today you even tried to stand up and let her speak.
Hey, you shut up, Jason.
Normally, you're like...
I'm finished. I will. Yes, sir. But the thing was, Fester, but MJ, it seems like if it's not about you, you can't wait. You'll go into detail about an OG rice maker that makes 6 grains a millimeter and you served it with this pate. It's like, dude, we get it, but let's hear from the female.
Yeah.
Even if you don't believe, I get it. You don't have to believe,
all right.
But let's hear her experience.
Good point, Scott.
We haven't even got to truly hear her. If you ask the guy who filters your call.
Jason, but listen, dude, Jason, we've spent...
Doing it again. I'm going to finish. Yes, sir. Jason,
we've spent 35 minutes on this now.
Do you know you would have spent less on it if you'd let her just straight talk?
That's true.
Yes, Jason.
You're interrupting the joke.
Jason, thank you. Listen.
Even when she was getting teary-eyed, you said, oh, that's going to make it harder for me to make a joke. Like, whoa.
Yeah. But Jason.
Roxanne, what did the text line look like?
Jason. But listen, that's the show, man. I mean,
listen.
I know it's the MJ show, and you never let us forget it's the MJ show. What is it?
Jason.
We all have to get. Let's tell 3 people about MJ, and let's up to his social media with MJ and MJ social media.
That's a good impression. Hey, Jason,
all right, this guy's got my number.
Jason, tell me everything you've learned about rice cookers in the last 2 weeks.
Jason, have a great day. That could be the best call of the day.
He's right.
Megan, he's right. He's 100% right. All right, Megan is in Bartow. Megan, you're on the MJ Morning Show.
Good morning, y'all. So I just want to say that to Roxanne, you believe in what makes you comfortable. If that brings you comfort for you and your beautiful family, then you believe it. I've been a nurse for 23 years, and things that have happened and I've experienced personally from patients that pass, you can't explain that. So I do know that there are angels out there that come down to visit us from time to time. So you just believe in what you feel makes you comfortable and brings happiness. I love y'all. Have a good day. I got to go clock into work. Y'all, I love y'all.
Thank you.
Oh, that's fine. Sorry to hold you up.
Yeah, sorry.
All right, so Megan, you don't hate me for what I do?
I don't hate anybody.
Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you, Megan. Deanna is St. Pete.
Hey, nice to talk to you finally after years. My first time getting through to you.
Well, you're on.
I went to a Renaissance festival with a girlfriend one time, and she said, let's go to this card reader. I asked, no, that's stupid. She goes, no, let's try it. Okay, whatever. Well, when she read my card, she said, well, you have a boyfriend, and he's already gone. I said, oh, that's silly. We live together, and we pay rent together. We do everything together, you know. That's stupid. I come home, and he didn't come home. Well, that's kind of odd. Well, maybe he got drunk somewhere, you know, whatever. So next day, he still didn't come home.
Jeez.
On the third day, I text. I said, are you either in jail, you're dead, or what happened to you? And he goes, no, he went left, and he went to another woman. He's living with another woman.
I thought you were going to say dead.
Before I even
knew. Thought you were going to say he like. I thought you were going to say he like he was in a construction accident and got run over by a steamroller or something.
That's what I was thinking. Nope. Just like you said, he's already gone.
Deanna, thank you very much. I appreciate you getting through finally. Okay.
Finally, thanks.
You bet. What day are you going to the Renaissance Festival?